And action.
Is that what I'm supposed to say? What am I supposed to say? Oh, that's right.
No, I just wanted to tell you that I love you.
I love you too, Daddy.
You tend to find that most actors are quite weird about watching themselves back on screen, but you have this breadth of work that kind of is like your childhood on celluloid. Is that odd to re-experience that on a screen?
Yeah, it's particularly when you are promoting a film like, you know, with The Sixth Sense or with AI or something. I back in the day saw both of those movies like 10 times in a very short amount of time on top of, you know, remembering the experience of making them. So it's not weird for me to watch them, but it's hard for me to find a reason to go back and watch those now, although they're movies, I would really enjoy as an audience member, not just because I was in them, but the memory of them is just so strong with me that it's not weird to see it played back.
So in the minds of a lot of people, you just like disappeared for almost a decade. But you had a normal upbringing. You went to college and stuff like that, didn't you?
Yes, in 2006, I went to NYU and I graduated in 2011.
When you were making that decision to kind of go from Hollywood to New York and become a grown up and go to college, was there ever that moment of just like, actually, no, I just want to stay a kid. I just want to stay making movies?
I don't really have any regrets like that. You know, when it comes to stepping away, like to go to college and everything, that was a trade-off that, I knew what happened was that, you know, you're not so much in the public eye when you're going off and studying. I studied experimental theater at NYU. And it being such an unpredictable industry, you know, there's sometimes you make films, they don't get, you know, good films that don't get a distribution, or a film goes in development and it doesn't get its money. Those are really tough things to predict. So for me, it was always important to just focus on how I could do my job the best and, focus on the art of it.
How to get the show on the road? I'm getting some quality time alone with Emily. What's the running time on these?
Is it ever a bit odd being back in movies, being back in the public eye? Do you get strange reactions from people?
I guess there hasn't really been a strange reaction, but it's been fun seeing people surprised at what the character is.
This is my son, Travis. He's gonna sit in with us if you don't mind.
Because when it comes to Entourage, you know, there's so many cameos and things, and I think a lot of people go in expecting me to be playing myself, and Travis is a completely different character that's within the reality of the movie, and, you know, I guess you could say the villain for the movie, and it's fun to be able to sort of subvert people's expectations with that.
Look, I'm real sorry about earlier, Vince, but that Ari wouldn't let me be heard.
He's probably just being protective of me. He's like that.
Well, I'm just being protective of my money. I'm like that. Look at this. This must be the data space.
One of the things people might not necessarily know about you is that you spend a lot of your time in the world of video games. You've voiced a bunch of different video game characters.
And then we can go see Santa.
Once upon a time, we used to watch movies. They lasted 90 minutes, but in an age of, you know, long TV shows and video games, people are now immersed in narratives that last hours and hours and hours. Do you think that's changing the way we think about stories?
Absolutely. I think it's both reflective of people's increased capacity for long and complex storylines that in television series like Game of Thrones can unspool over many, many years and can be huge and epic in scope. I think video games have definitely encouraged that relationship to story, because just the hours that you spend with those games, you know, really sort of increase your tolerance for stories that unfold over a long period of time. And I think it's kind of cool how those two things are interrelated.
I'm wondering, like, what's the biggest change you've seen in the business as you've kind of progressed through?
One of the things that's really changed the way movies are promoted and how, you know, some of them, the decision of how some of them get made, is just social media is really a big decider of a lot of that. It's just funny to think back, like, when I went to college and we got the Facebook email. Like, I was like, oh, I guess that's the like sign-up sheet for the college or whatever. Like, just being totally oblivious to the way the world was gonna change. So, and how it would change our industry.
I see dead people.
You are the owner of probably one of the most quoted lines of cinema in history. I'm fascinated to know, like, what's your internal reaction? Like, when somebody says, I see dead people, do you cringe, or is there some distance there that you're okay with it now?
With the distance of, you know, as many years as it's been now, it's just crazy to me that it's had that that long life, and it's kind of cool because it's a movie that I think we were all really proud of, and the fact that it's you know, still so much in the public consciousness is always amazing to me, particularly because when we were making it, that line didn't stand out to us. We weren't on set going like, oh, this is gonna be the tagline for the movie. It just, it slipped by everybody. And then when the film came out, it became the, you know, the sort of tagline associated with it.